Yeah, this car's going down, nigga.
All we need is a stage. God.
Yeah. Come on. It's on and popping, baby. Last Temptation.
Yes, he's
back. Y'all know what I'm talking about. To the world over.
And that New York game. Come on.
Dealing with this.
What? Come on.
You miss my loving, my talking, my loving.
That New York game.
I know you're living your life faithfully, safely, you wait for me, but you miss being next to me, don't you? Don't let a love hold you, lust for what you want, and go for your guns and back out on anyone who tries to interfere or intervene. Of me peeling your wide body out of them tight jeans, wrist on freeze, seats on lean, shoes 19, coming through in that new Bentley thing. The talk of the town, the change of the city. You and I make headlines like Lowe and Diddy or Bob and Whitney. I'm here for the Lord sent me. Pound puss like a pugilist. Grin real devilish and freak bad bitches. Shit, you will get the story. I know you're getting bored and that nigga ain't getting your horny no more, is it? Cause when it's all said and done, it's me.
Loving, thugging, you and me. Don't get bored. Dealing with it. I know you miss my loving.
I'm living it. Won't you let me let you live it a little bit? I know a stressful relationship is hard to deal with, but here's how you deal with it. On your weekly visits, use a code name to protect the innocent. Maybe I'm too generous, generally believing that all women want me, they don't want to get even. But who do you believe in? Is it money or God? Betrayal, trust, the staying of vows. Should be secretly held sacred. Cause I love it when you pop your body, body. Move your body, body. Bring up all the Bacardi and run up alongside me. I love to see you wild and free. But occasionally you get cold, wet feet. And all that means to me is you need my heat. Cause when it's said and done, you're gonna want me.
Loving, thugging, you have paid your game.
Girl, I'm holding your love hostage. A ransom for you, she could be priceless. Cause you've been getting at me in many a ways. Now take a minute, watch this back and duck from strays. Cause I've been in a rage lately. Hoping God will forgive me for all the sinning, all the women, all the drama I've been in. And this is just the beginning. I hope you, so you can see that nigga ain't built like me. The black sheep of my family. But we one and the same. That's why we get along. Break off and get it on. When we make love, look at something like soft porn. Now tell me, baby, do you really wanna go home to him? But the brightest of days, just look dim. You fucking with a loser, baby. You can't win. When it's all said and done, you're gonna need me.
Loving, thugging, you have been your game. Dealing with you.
Come on.
I know you miss my loving.
This is what we built in here. Classic shit. Murder Inc.
Be proud.
Bringing back my nigga.
God damn it. Look at this shit here. Now tell me if this ain't no motherfucking gangster shit here. B
Big Brown and motherfucking Ja Rule. IG, you son of a bitch, you did it again. Motherfuckers bought B Brown back. Ain't that some shit? I'm motherfucking Big Remo in this bitch. I'm here to let you know. We ain't playing, man.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. You know, I just thought I would just pop in for a real quick minute. Why don't y'all tell that nigga to take his goddamn Martin Luther King, motherfucking Medgar Evers, goddamn Emmett Till, motherfucking speech and shove it up his motherfucking ass? Why don't y'all tell that old decrepit nigga, that wannabe geriatric gangbanger, that wannabe from Philly, but bitch you could never be? You don't have the testicular fortitude to be a Philly nigga. You don't even have the testicular fortitude to be a Philly bitch. Get into it. You ain't built for this shit, bitch. Until you can stop fucking with folks online and then carrying your pump, pussified, sissified motherfucking ass down there with your tights underneath of your gabardine dress pants, bitch. Until you can stop bringing your bitch ass on camera at a motherfucking police station, you punk ass bitch. Stop acting as if you are a representation of the niggas in our city. Philly, stand the fuck up. We in this bitch. And these motherfuckers are in their fucking feelings about it. And guess what? What can you do about it? Not a goddamn thing. Not a goddamn thing. Nobody wants to hear your goddamn Medgar Evers motherfucking crumpled up in your goddamn pocket, your motherfucking polyester pants wearing penis pump using bitch. Don't nobody want to hear that shit you talking about. That ain't what the pretense of the goddamn beef sector is based on. Don't nobody want to hear you preaching. Don't nobody want to hear you and them old, haggard, decrepit motherfucking hoes with they arthritic motherfucking hands holding circles singing Kumbaya, bitch. Get your ass off of the motherfucking internet and go be a daddy to that goddamn fat cabbage patch bitch you call a daughter. How about that part? He could preach to every motherfucking body, but that fat cupcake loving bitch, that's the fruit of your motherfucking loins, to lay off of the motherfucking snacks. Clearly, that you talking about motherfucker's childhood, clearly, that bitch stuffed her motherfucking pain down her motherfucking throat. And to her goddamn large motherfucking intestine. Why weren't you this goddamn knowledgeable when your own goddamn daughter was growing the fuck up? Now you got so much knowledge and so much wisdom. He's so knowledgeable about every motherfucking thing, but how to put a goddamn wedding ring on a bitch goddamn index finger. He all about the goddamn family. He can keep every goddamn thing together, but you couldn't stay in a relationship or marry the mother of your motherfucking child, but you out here preaching to motherfuckers about how the fuck they should be living their motherfucking life. You want to talk about what motherfuckers got and ain't got? Tell me, motherfucker. Why have you not been able to find current debt in my motherfucking name? Why do you have current debt in your name right now, bitch, in 2021? Why you up here talking about what folks got or ain't got? See, it's one of two things. You can't have it both ways. Either I live in a goddamn 9-bedroom house on Ontario Street, or either I don't, bitch. You don't get to have it both ways. So I guess I gotta translate. What's up, everybody in the chat? How y'all doing this morning? Let me go through the chat. Got D Cop, Win Shanty, Blackberry Babes, Dr. Lashonia Roos Brown, Vanessa J, Natasha, Coco Puff, Blackberry Babes, Jungle Jane, The Mean Girl, Egyptian Goddess, Natisha, Miss Pretty Wings, Wave Principal, the motherfucking Church of Diet Melanin is in the motherfucking building, Voodoo, Warmy, Deborah Cobbs, Better Days, Battle Roach, Nate Wilson. I'm good, Nate. How are you? Moon Harvester, Prayed Up, LV, Demir, Dory, Diamond to Pearl, my bro, my Philly bro, Hanlon Jones in the building, Pandora's Box, Sexy Star, Cheryl Brown, I see you over there, sis, doing your damn thing with the cooking. Soap and Wash, good morning. Send my love to Lady Nika. Cold as Ice, good morning. Lena, Pretty Brown Eyes. I think I got everybody. If I missed anybody, I apologize. Hey, Savage Life 718. Hey, Tay Day. BAP 0485. Yes, Cheryl Brown. I see you over there doing your thing. Hey, Shady. Hey, Blind Spot. Free Thinker. Amethyst Heart. Told to Bree. RNRRNY. So. Hypnotic touch, touch. Good morning, everybody. So here's the thing about it is, one of the things that I told y'all about these, about ZX in particular, he's very jealous hearted. And at the end of the goddamn day, you pathetic excuse for a goddamn human being. Okay. You pile of motherfucking human waste. Okay. You got to answer for every motherfucking thing except for why the fuck your motherfucking bills ain't paid, bitch. You got an excuse for every goddamn thing about why you got so much goddamn money, but you gotta go around there down to the Home Depot and steal some shit to furnish your goddamn house with. And then leave your mama's address in the motherfucking Richard Allen Projects for the goddamn bill collectors to motherfucking harass. You got answers for everything except for why the fuck your goddamn business is motherfucking imaginary. Why you lied about running a goddamn, owning a goddamn trucking company where you claim you was teaching people, right? Mr. Recruiter. Nigga, you ain't nothing. Listen, that shit that you souped up on your goddamn Facebook page, guess what, motherfucker? You ain't nothing but a goddamn glorified motherfucker that stand on corners and pass out goddamn flyers. The only goddamn difference is you're doing it indoors. Kiss my entire black motherfucking ass, bitch. You got to answer for every goddamn thing except for why the fuck your motherfucking bills ain't paid. You got to answer for every goddamn thing other than why the fuck you were not able to take the motherfucking second house that you swindled out of a goddamn senior citizen that you preyed on and stopped and stalked after you found her goddamn house listed on the goddamn sheriff's sale, which is public information. And what they encourage you to do is to go look at the house before you do your goddamn bidding. See, you did one better, you old decrepit bitch. And you went and stalked with your fake so-called motherfucking messianic motherfucking ass. You took your fake fugazi ass around there and stalked the woman. How do we know that? Because God is a fact. Who used to be Nikki Baker friend until you triangulated them, right? And cause division. with your divide and conquer motherfucking strategies. Ain't nobody from the goddamn beef sector coming over there to your goddamn channel for no goddamn kumbaya, kumbaya and fucking peace and harmony. I think it's pathetic that you got to get your old 55-year-old motherfucking ass up there. And why do they like Cookie? Read. Native Philadelphian, why won't you accept me? I'm the 55-year-old phony pretending to be a gangster nigga from Richard Allen in fucking Philly. Why don't you choose me, Reed? Beef Sector, why don't you like me? Because they know you phony. Ain't nobody coming over there to listen to no nigga that they've seen in black and white as a broke ass bitch. Talk about shit. All them bitches lined up over there to sit on your dick. I don't know why the nigga can't use it no more. He cannot use his penis without assistance. In order for that nigga to get an erection, he probably need one of the gay males, openly gay males from the goddamn beef sector to play with his motherfucking asshole. That's probably what it would take for him to get a goddamn erection. Hey, JoJo dancing. Ain't nobody interested in playing in your old ancient motherfucking asshole. I done told you that. Carry your goddamn McDonald's arch heaven in your in the root of your motherfucking mouth. Ass somewhere and sit the fuck down, old man. Nobody gives a fuck about none of that shit you talking about. The nigga wants somebody to dildo him in his ass. Like he was dildoing himself in the ass when he was jacking off the Let's Get It. He over there in the beef sector for no, you over there in the beef sector for no other reason than to look for somebody to dig your asshole out, old man. Don't nobody want your ancient anus. Have a goddamn seat. You sugar baby head bitch. Y'all remember the sugar babies? This nigga's over there filtering his goddamn pictures to look like he a light-skinned nigga. Nigga, you look like motherfucking pig pen off of the motherfucking goddamn peanuts. When I seen the ass nigga up close and personal, that nigga ain't light skin. He's over there filtering his goddamn pictures. Nigga, the only goddamn thing you missing is the use of the goddamn flower motherfucking headbands. Hey, chocolate. The nigga is old. He look like the motherfucking way. Listen. The nigga is old and funky. He came out the house funky and dirty. Why this nigga can show you every goddamn thing but a motherfucking washing machine and motherfucking dryer? He can show you everything but how he washing his ass without no goddamn gas. And you ain't washing your ass with no gas on, bitch, until you pay down around there to the Philadelphia Gas Works that goddamn $5,000 that you owe. You came out the motherfucking house smelling like you washed your ass with water that's been heated up in the motherfucking crock pot. Ain't nobody trying to hear that bullshit you talking about, bitch. Period. You ain't paid that gas bill, and I want you to lie about it, bitch, so I can dox your motherfucking ass again. I doxed you because you doxed me, bitch. Your mama got doxed because you doxed me, bitch. I didn't know your motherfucking mother lived in Richard Allen motherfucking projects. Ain't no goddamn body tell you to put your mama's address and Richard Allen projects on your goddamn business application. You goddamn glorified motherfucking scammer. Why don't you open up that goddamn Facebook group with your Ankh Dashiki wearing motherfucking ass and let the folks over here on YouTube get access to the motherfuckers on Facebook you was finessing before you ran your ass over here to YouTube looking for new goddamn victims to target, bitch. All these bitches lined up to sit on a dick this nigga can't even use. You must have intentions on bringing one of them gay men from the goddamn beef sector with you when you go to fuck the nigga. Because the nigga gonna have to play in his ass for him to get turned on with for you. The nigga, listen, come on. I'm tired of playing games with motherfuckers. Hey, younger sibling. Hey, beautiful soul. Good morning. He's about my height. Black man, and I'm 5'5". If you look at the pictures, you can see we was almost like eye to eye. He's about my height. Maybe I give him about 5'6". Hey, Hawk for life. Yeah, he's not tall. He's not tall at all. If you look at the pictures, you can see the nigga came out the house smelling like he had just finished, like I had woke him up from a wet dream where he was laying there playing his motherfucking asshole, rolling around in his goddamn vomit. He smelled like he washed his ass up with water he heated up in a motherfucking crock pot. After the water been sitting there for a couple of days. Basically, he's over there and I'm listening to him talk. And again, you have to let people see things for themselves. Now, what I told Reed was that, Reed, this nigga ain't one of us. And see, a lot of times people will take two people from Philadelphia communicating with each other as disrespect. No, we know what disrespect is. We know when we're disrespecting each other or when we're being disrespectful. There's a certain way that we communicate with each other. We can communicate with each other without even communicating to each other. There's different things that we will say, different verbiages that we will use. So to other people, we roast each other as a way to express our affection. So most of Philadelphians, native Philadelphians, have pretty thick skin. Especially from the older generations, because we didn't grow up having all of this gadgets and shit that they have now for fucking entertainment. We used to do what we call bussing on each other for entertainment. When we go to our family gatherings, that's the first thing we start doing, what they call playing the dozens, is cracking jokes on our family members. We do that with our friends. We do that with our neighbors, and it's no harm intended. So other people might say, oh, well, they would know that's not disrespect. We know what disrespect is. Or we know when we're saying something that's disrespectful to another native Philadelphian, okay? Or somebody that's familiar with people from Philadelphia, okay? So because you have to allow people to have their own experiences with an individual. I was trying to prepare both you and Rita for what was to come. And make no mistake about it, although he's not calling anybody else from the beef sector out that supports me or supports my channel or that rocks with me or when I go live or whatever, that's he hasn't gotten to that yet. I think it's absolutely disgusting that a 55-year-old man would have to go live and continuously talk about me and how many people like, motherfucker, they don't like you because they don't like you. They don't like you. As a rule of thumb, most people just don't navigate to motherfuckers that are real. People are not going to find a fake phony motherfucker that doesn't, you don't, nothing over there that you talk about is real shit. It's real to you. It's not real to real people who live life on turn. See, it's you. Let me explain something to you. One of the reasons why this nigga's always in his fucking feelings. Again, he doxed me first and he doxed Suge first. He was running around here poverty shaming people about their struggle. But when it came to why the fuck he didn't pay his motherfucking bills, he had a fucking excuse. It was about the COVID. Everything is because of COVID. No, nigga, you weren't paying your fucking bills prior to COVID because you, like a lot of niggas, make it a point to try to look like you fucking got money that you ain't fucking got. What's real about that? What's real about that? Guess what, motherfucker? I can eat a porterhouse steak. I can eat pig feet. And I can eat some pork flavored motherfucking oodles and noodles and some pork rinds to survive if I had to, bitch. And that's just the realness of it. Do somebody really give a fuck? Hey, Angel, if, hey, IB, if motherfuckers rent or if they own, fuck no. Y'all are the motherfuckers that shame motherfuckers for that reason. I wouldn't give a fuck, quite frankly, if a motherfucker lived in a tent out in the motherfucking woods with all of their motherfucking children. Philadelphia has a large population of homeless people. Anytime a motherfucker from Philadelphia is telling you that they give a fuck about their community, Philly Bruja goes out to the park. Philly Bruja takes and prepares care packages and takes and goes and gives those things out with boots on the ground community service. She don't get on YouTube and raise money to do that. She don't ask motherfuckers to give her money to do that. That's her way of giving back. It's a large homeless population, not only in Center City, but in the Kensington section of Philadelphia. If anybody is genuinely interested in giving back to their community, that will be the first place that they could start. Do you honestly believe motherfuckers that look down their nose at people based on whether or not they're renting or whether they're owning really give a fuck about the homeless people? If a nigga gets up here and shames women, although his mother, the mother that he's telling y'all that he loves and cares about so much. Do you really think prior to him getting popped and motherfuckers finding out that his mom lived in Richard Allen Projects? Do you honestly believe a person that talks about welfare, food stamps, Section 8, do you think they give a fuck about the people in their community? What community do you live in? If you don't live in an upper middle class, ZX does not live in no upper middle class motherfucking neighborhood. Don't let those pictures fucking fool you. ZX lives in the gutter part of Philadelphia. The only people that don't fucking know that are people that are not native Philadelphians. He don't live in no fucking suburb. He don't live in no middle class motherfucking neighborhood. He lives in the fucking hood. That's the realness of it. Do you think motherfuckers that live in the neighborhood would go look at the goddamn crime statistics for his motherfucking address? What do you think lives, where do you, who do you think lives around him? Who do you think he lives around? He has y'all convinced because he's showing y'all the inside the house of his house or the porch. Tell the nigga to take you for a tour around the community. It's the fucking hood. So yeah, he's able to get up here. People that doxed this nigga probably seen that address 1,000 times over and did not know that that was Richard Allen motherfucking projects. I used to go to elementary school at Spring Garden Elementary right down the street from where the fuck his mama lives at. Do you think a person that shames people really cares about their community? No, they don't. They really don't. They use that when it's convenient. When it's convenient for them to say, I can relate to the struggle. I know what the struggle is. You don't know what the fuck a struggle is, ZX, because you're used to finessing bitches for your sustenance and covering. Bitches pay your bills. You live off of bitches. You just happen to get lucky and run down stalking a senior citizen that was getting ready to die and wanted to die in the house that her and her husband lived in. She wanted to die in that house. What properties? Here's the whole thing. Have you asked the motherfucker why did he not own a property prior to those two properties with Miss Hazel? Surely he had a fixer upper or something of the sort prior to meeting Miss Hazel and swindling her out of those houses, pretending to be what? A person that cared. But he was on Facebook talking about the woman like a goddamn dog. Talking about how the woman was a hoarder. How did the people on ZX's Facebook group know that Miss Hazel was a hoarder? Because he would get online bashing the woman. Talking about how filthy and how dirty she was. Nonetheless, it didn't stop you from agreeing to buy those houses from her. Did that money that you paid for those houses for come out of your own bag? No, it didn't. You committed income tax fraud in order to get that with your straw business. And that's the fact of the matter. You committed fraud in order to get the money that you used to make the down payment. Prior to that, at what age would he have been? Certainly, you would have been in your 40s by the time that house was purchased, right? Why is there no record in any state that you've ever lived in of you owning a property prior to you swindling Hazel out of those houses? I'm not impressed. Move around, country boy. Move around, dirty foot country boy. My mouth is vile. It ain't no motherfucking viler than your mother's throat and pussy was when she was fucking and sucking at 14. You got the answers for every motherfucking thing except for who the fuck your daddy is. You got the answers for everything but who your daddy is. Your daddy is probably that cross-dressing motherfucker that was your auntie with that goddamn Balsillini to fuck on with the goddamn feather in it with the goddamn mustache. Hey, C, what's up, baby? Hey, Big Chief. The That's probably who taught you how to squeeze your long gray head nuts into a goddamn pair of tights that you bought from the goddamn Dominicans. Talking about they was pajamas. Diet, you know what? You need to bring up that Diet is really funny, y'all. Y'all gotta see that parody Diet. You need to set up a live stream where you show the beef sector that parody that you did of ZX. Y'all want to see some hilarious shit? That is some funny shit. Diet nailed that shit. Okay? Don't nobody want to hear your old ass. See, this is the reason why a lot of folks don't respect your generation. See, you ain't did a motherfucking thing for the damn generations that's coming after you. And you think just because you were old, nigga, somebody's supposed to listen to you. Maybe they would listen to you if you actually listened to them. See, that's a problem with your old motherfuckers. You always trying to tell motherfuckers something. You don't listen. You want to talk at people, not talk to people, or actually have conversations with people and respect what their struggle is. That's why y'all got to get up here and pretend with all of these facades and stuff that your life is perfect, that your upbringing was perfect. Your mama was a fucking hoe that was fucking at 14. The bitch damn near 80 years old. That bitch was fucking and sucking when goddamn Eve was eating the motherfucking apple in the goddamn Garden of Eden. Who the fuck are you to preach to anybody about any goddamn thing? How did that old decrepit cancer head ridden bitch live out her? How is she living out her days? In fucking poverty? Do your mama have a car? Does your mama have a car? All of this energy that you invest in folks on YouTube's motherfucking business, do you invest that time in your own child? Fuck no. That's why she ain't nowhere around you. And if anybody had any goddamn sense, that's the question they will be asking. Where is his family? Why don't we fuck that picture shit, nigga? We ain't heard another living person in your background since you been on YouTube. Why don't you go on and tell the truth? Your first male crush on YouTube was goddamn Nature Boy. You, like many of them other motherfuckers that used to be commentators on them, you wanted nothing more than a sucker's dick. Why were you offering him $50,000? You're going to have to explain you care so much about the children. Why were you offering Nature Boy $50,000 that we know goddamn well you ain't have in some motherfucking land? Why? Because you wanted to have your old geriatric ass down there hula hooping and goddamn Honolulu-ing. Having a goddamn luau with your own motherfucking old decrepit ass in a goddamn grass skirt, you old freak. You wanted to be down there sucking the nectar out of the goddamn coconuts and shit and from the fucking trees and shit. You wanted to suck the nectar out the goddamn coconuts and massage Nature Boy coconuts at the same time, bitch. Get into it. Anybody about to sit up here and keep playing with your old ass? Keep my name out your mouth, you old bitch. It's not a motherfucking thing around here. Listen, you ain't gonna say or do or stop a motherfucking thing I'm doing, you old bitch. Figure out how to wash your ass correctly with that goddamn hot water that you're heating up. You ain't showering, but you around here talking about somebody else's hygiene. How good is your hygiene when you ain't got no goddamn hot water? I wouldn't be surprised if your old ass had a dishwasher and you took the rack out of it and crawled your old decrepit ass into that and washed your ass. That's what you smelt like you did before you came out that goddamn door. Nobody want to, no goddamn body from the beef sector comes over this motherfucker to hear your goddamn Martin Luther King speeches. He gonna go over there and he gonna preach to the beef sector. But no, nigga, you wasn't preaching to the beef sector. You wasn't even preaching to Reed. In so many words, sis, the translation is everything that you did not tell you, these motherfucking hypocritical phonies don't give a fuck about the truth. They don't care, sis. See, if you had a platform the size of Five Babes, or Pat, he basically told all of y'all in that live stream who matters over there in the beef sector. If you didn't fall, if he didn't mention your name, if you weren't among the honorable mentions, then he don't perceive that there's anything that his old dry. Listen, if you think QB don't know how to read, tell that nigga to have Nikki Baker go live one more again. And sing and read, I Know Why the Cage Bird Sings. You want some fuck? You want to entertain the beef sector? Have Nikki Baker, aka Nikki Pope, get her old decrepit ass up there. Tell her to get her countrified ass up there and read, I Know Why the Cage Bird Sings. And you'll go back to having eight motherfuckers in your chat room because ain't nobody trying to sit there and hear no remedial country bitch reading. Stop acting like you don't know what brings the numbers in. Ain't nobody coming in to hear your old funky ass talking. Hey, Clementine. Hey, the back lady. But they think everybody's stupid. See, you can get off with that with the people that aren't from this sector. This nigga said he fed the sector. How did you feed this sector when you just got to this sector? You're not a vet in this sector. The Nature Boy sector and the Tea Sipper sector just merged with the Black sector. You're not a vet in this sector. You're not some sector historian. All of the information that you got from second parties or third parties. Stop acting like you some goddamn authoritarian on what goes on, who's who, and then motherfucker, you know, I know goddamn well you new to this sector when you didn't fucking know who the fuck Bomb Cherry was. You didn't know who Bomb Cherry was. You didn't know what the Viper Pit was. And for those of y'all that don't know, Bomb Cherry was the only content creator on this platform, not just in this sector, on this platform that wasn't afraid to drop a link and allow me to come on the panel and to actually be myself. Nor did she allow anybody else to critique and control how I showed up. That's with me, STL, Shantastic, Six Figure Days. This dude ain't no historian in this sector. So how the fuck did you feed this sector? Are you fucking kidding me? You can tell that bullshit to motherfuckers who don't know the history. You just got to this sector when the beef when the black sector, the tea sippers, and the Nature Boy sector merged. You ain't feed no sector. It's some people in this sector that don't even know who the fuck you are. Guess what? They don't give a fuck neither. Bob Cherry was one of the first content creators in this entire sector that used to have marathon live streams. Bob used to go to sleep, tend to her family, her husband and the children, now she got a grandbaby, and leave me in STL and other people from the Viper Pit to basically hold it there. She didn't care about the trolls. I used to drive me nuts. But unless somebody was a racist that came into the chat that said certain shit, they were not allowed to be blocked. Even though we were moderators, we were not allowed to block other people that came into the that came into the chat. That's where I met Beasley at. Beasley, now you want to talk about old people, people that have been here. You talk about Beasley, Vic Damone, those are the people that have been here. They may have been here longer than most people here in this sector. But he's not no vet in this sector or somebody that knows a lot of history. Somebody that would know a lot of history about this sector would be somebody like Beasley or Vic Damone. They've been here forever. So no, I don't acknowledge him as somebody that's been in this motherfucking sector that can give you history on this sector. He don't know half the people in this sector. I can open up the panel and invite people from the sector and I can guarantee you they don't know and won't give a fuck who a ZX is. Right, Diet. Beasley is an OG in this sector. And even though you may see him in my chat, me and him are beefing right now at the moment. But it ain't about shit. Okay? But no, he's not the... But to drive the point home, as I close in, because I'm going to make my grandson some lunch. When it comes to other content creators, yes, you do have to allow people to get to know other content creators for themselves. Well, guess what, bitch? I keep you enough in your motherfucking feelings that you had to go create a troll account to bring your faceless ass in here. You prove the point, bitch. You got so much in your feelings, you had to go create a troll account. Drop down from out of the clouds to talk some shit that I don't give no fucks about, bitch. If you were really that unbothered, you would have had the self-discipline to stay your ass in the clouds, bitch. If you were that unbothered. If you were that unbothered, you would not have had to drop down from the clouds to say a goddamn thing. You just would have went on about your way, bitch. There you go. This is the prime example of a bitch that wants to be relevant. An unseen bitch that wants to be seen. There you go. Are you happy now? Bye, bitch. Go carry your motherfucking ass over there with that goddamn peanuts, penis pump using, crock pot asshole washing, wanting a motherfucker from the beef sector to play in his asshole and tickle his prostate gland, ass motherfucker nigga. Bitch, get your ass out my chat. Go somewhere and die a slow and painful death, bitch. Hopefully you'll die with a goddamn dildo up your motherfucking ass with somebody tickling your motherfucking anus, bitch. Your anus and your motherfucking esophagus at the same time, bitch. Nobody give a fuck about what you talking about. Period. So, basically, in other words, sis, see, when people are telling the truth and you have a desire, when people have integrity, right? Or you have a desire, if somebody is lying on you, or if somebody is telling the story out of chronological order, you know what went over his head in that entire story? Because I didn't hear Pizarro's live stream last night in its entirety, but I caught some of the replay with Shish Trish on the panel and Pizarro on the panel. See, in order for you to know the history, even though they've hidden those live streams and those videos may no longer be available, sometimes your only source of information is the people that have actually been there. Now, had his clout chasing ass actually taken the time to listen, he would have heard both Pizarro and Shish Trish say, yes, Rita did eventually drag her child, but it took Rita a year and a half of Fabe attacking her special needs child before she responded. See, those type of things, sis, go over their head. They don't have an interest in truth. See, to accept the truth or to embrace the truth, even what you said when it came down to Tracy, none of that fits his hidden agenda and in his ulterior motives, which is to be a send-off for Fabi. He doesn't care about the truth. Did you notice how he constantly harped on you leaving it alone? You letting it go. Did he say one time to Fabi, see, this will be the test of the hypocrisy. Tell him to keep that same energy when it comes to Fabi. Tell her to let it go. You know why Fabi wouldn't let it go? Because that's not the pretense that the beef sector is built upon. They beef back and forth with each other. So his perspective, there's no logic in his perspective. Not when you really see, that was the reason, when you think about it, sis, that's the reason why he drugged Fabi in the first place. Why did he start attacking her? Because she would not take his side when it came to his enemies. Because he could not convince people. Why did he turn on Tracy? Why did he turn on Tracy and start attacking Tracy? Because Tracy was not 100% in agreement with him. Tracy's platform wasn't going to be an echo chamber to push his narratives, his perspectives, and the position that he took on certain situations. I think it's pathetic that a grown 55-year-old man has to get up on his platform and try to convince grown-ass men and women who they should like based on who he likes and gets along with in that moment. That's all that was about, sis. Basically, what he sat there and said was that everything, you breaking down the chronological history meant absolutely nothing. That whatever you feel about your child being dragged, whether it's about your child being dragged or about you being doxxed, you should be the bigger person and be willing to let it go. Tell him to keep that same energy with Fabi. He's not one of us, sis. He doesn't move. That's the reason why he doesn't move like Philadelphians move. Hell, I don't like Obsidian. Me and Obsidian, or Obsidian is my arch nemesis, but I wasn't going to dox the nigga. For Nala says. See, that's where you draw the motherfucking line. And the other thing about Native Philadelphians, guess what? If whether or not me and Reed cuss each other out, that's none of your motherfucking business. That's in-house business. Native Philadelphians will fight each other, stop me in the middle of the fight, fuck you up, and then go back to fighting each other when we finish. That's what we give. That's how the fuck we give it up. Don't even bother meddling in business between Native Philadelphians. That's in-house business. And that's just the realness of it. Okay? Rita, you got me saying that shit. That's just the realness of it. I kind of like that. You know? But yeah, that's the shit. Well, listen, we will stop. Fight. We will be tearing each other's ass out the frame, stop fighting to go fight some other motherfuckers, and then go back to resume the fight when we finish. Because that's our business. So don't worry about whether or not me and Reed argue or whatever. If we do, we do. Why is that your business? It'll be something for you to give commentary about, but that's about as far as it goes. But that dude is not one of us, sis. He's not. So he's not going to move how we move. And he ain't going to keep it gutter how we keep it gutter. He's over there in the beefs again. Like I said, last night. I caught it this morning, the replay this morning. Shish Tris, let me tell you something, you wolf pussy having ass bitch. Nobody said you had to be, and stop trying to start. I like the intels. Stop trying to start shit between me, Pizarro, Brianna, Reed, Rita, and anybody else over there I fuck with the long way. Knock it the fuck off. Let me tell you something, wolf pussy bitch. Don't nobody want to see no wolf pussy bitch up there on a motherfucking spaceship, bitch. You think you slick, bitch. You over there looking for some of that young intel pussy. You ain't fooling nobody, bitch. So nobody said you had to be afraid of me, bitch. I would never be afraid of a bitch named Shish Trish, bitch. Get into it. I go to log on to watch the replay, and I got to sit up there and listen to this thick hair wolf pussy bitch talking shit on the goddamn spaceship. But I digress. It's not about me and my personal feelings. But if she had listened to what was being said, if he had listened to what was being said, he would have realized that no, these women did not start. Even VS did not start attacking her child. She attacked other people's children. But because he has an ulterior motive and a hidden agenda, all of that preaching. What does Five Babes, here's the thing, sis. What does Five Babes' history, the history between you and Five Babe, have to do with you supporting me? See, he wants you to make a decision based on his personal feelings. He's a butthurt nigga. Be clear, he's never been fucking with my numbers. That's why the jealous bitch flagged two of my channels, fought on the false pretenses. He's always been a jealous, envious bitch. He's never been fucking with my numbers. And he has been jealous and envious of the black women in this sector that do the goddamn thing, that surpass him in support. And because he's a narcissistic prick with a sense of entitlement, he believes that the support that other women get, that he should get. Guess what? Has that nigga showed you a single motherfucking college degree? While he's over there doing all that goddamn preaching, tell that pussy to show you a goddamn GED or a goddamn high school diploma. Tell ZX to show you a college degree. See, because another thing narcissistic motherfuckers are notorious for doing, and that's surrounding themselves with accomplished motherfuckers because they have no accomplishments. So they use the people that are around them to somehow solidify their credibility. Nigga, where is your motherfucking GED, you old decrepit bitch? Where is your certificate of completion? Where are your college degrees? No, we're not talking about Coco. Because Coco is probably the only one over there that actually is educated formally. Where is your college degree? Where is your work history? No, we ain't talking about no shit that you had Nikki Baker go back and concoct. And I want you to keep putting out that fake ass resume that you had Nikki Baker doctor for your motherfucking ass so I can get on the goddamn phone and call those previous employers and find out whether or not your ass was ever employed there, you lying bitch. And I'll do it on a goddamn live stream. Show your college degrees. You want to talk about somebody else being broke? Explain your debt. Grown Folks TV 2.0 in fucking 2021, bitch. But you want to go back and dig up somebody else's goddamn credit from 16 and 24 motherfucking years ago. What about your debt that's current, bitch? I don't know whether or not Pastor Wilson got 7 degrees or not. Guess what? Don't give a fuck. I know. You know what I know? To a reasonable degree of certainty, bitch, you ain't got not a one. And your goddamn mama ain't got no motherfucking education the fuck either. Tell us about your mama's work history. Where did your mama work at? Tell us about how educated your mama is. Because then you will have to explain how her educated ass ended up 30% below the goddamn poverty line, bitch, with a son that claims to have been making $100,000 a motherfucking year. Make it make sense, bitch. Where is your mama's education? And you know I done already looked into it. Where is your mama's education? Where is your mama's work history? The only goddamn thing we know for a certainty is that the bitch was sucking dick at 14 and taking dick 9 times out of 10 by your granddaddy. No, your mama ain't never introduced you to your daddy. Your mama introduced you to your granddaddy, who is your motherfucking daddy. That's why you remedial and special needs. That's why you ought to have compassion. Because you got some goddamn learning disabilities going the fuck on because you think nobody can see through your bullshit. Where is your education? Where is your verifiable work history? This nigga done got up here and told folks that he was a social worker. But at the same time, he done told y'all, oh, y'all ain't fine. See, you're telling yourself, ZX, because the only way you got a deeper criminal history that was hidden is if you are a confidential informant. You keep talking about they didn't find the real shit. Are you in the witness protection program, sir? Because that's the only way your information wouldn't be a part of public record. So miss me with the bullshit. So here's the other thing. But the point is, he's telling y'all about this long, lengthy criminal history that he had. He's this thug that found his, that got on the straight and narrow path. You do realize that for motherfuckers that actually is their story. You do realize the fact that you got up here and told folks you used to be a caseworker. You know that don't make any sense, right? That your long criminal history of being with dealers, killers, and made men in the city of Philadelphia, you do realize that you claiming to be a social worker when you, or a caseworker when you first came to YouTube, doesn't make any sense. You do realize that if you were a caseworker, that would be verifiable, don't you, sir? So you another nigga that done got up here and lied about your life and lied about your accomplishments, but you ain't got the paperwork to show a goddamn thing. So no, you don't care if somebody, you don't care. No, you would be one to support somebody not verifying that a child that they initially told people they lost due to miscarriage has now suddenly manifested into a three-month-old baby that died tragically as a result of SIDS. And he's setting the stage so that if in the future Fire Babe does not fall into line or she crosses the line by saying, you know, yeah, you know, we get along, you know, right now. See, right now, nothing that Fire Babe has done or said about children is relevant. It's not going to be relevant, sis, until she does something to piss him off. Then he'll open up the panel and everything that was irrelevant that didn't matter, then will all of a sudden be relevant. One of his moderators, Southside Black Butterfly, told him Fire Babe's entire history on YouTube. She was one of the women that dragged Lady P for filth on ZX's panel. So nothing that you tell this dude is going to matter until Fire Babe doesn't fall into line or until she crosses the line. That's why QB was, and they understand that. That's why QB was over there backpedaling and pussy popping. But when he got angry, the truth about what he thought, didn't QB say that this dude was making rounds to all the females' platforms? Because he acknowledged he was a fucking predator. So what he did last night was nothing short of backpedaling and fucking pussy popping. See, no, sis, you and Rita should let it go. You and Rita should move on. What part about the people that have been calling out the fact that she doesn't take care of a child that Babe Nation does? What part are y'all not clocking about the fact that he called y'all all a bunch of jealous bitches? So he's mirroring what she said. Just like he said with the men in this sector that no, the men in this sector don't like you because you're a snake. The men in this sector don't like you because you're a snake. And you've doxed all of them. You doxed Beasley. You doxed Super Saiyan Jim. You doc shook. So it's interesting to me that he's sitting over there. He's Doc's diet husband. It's interesting that he sits, hey, Proud Grandma, that he sits over there And he's talking about old people can't take a roast and a gag. Well, again, and stop using our language. Stop ear hustling to our streams and then taking our commentary and regurgitating it. Since when have you been using projection? No, you project your hatred of your fucking mother. See, one of the other things that Goddess Effect said was that you are a nigga that has always tried to work. Your mother is disgusted by you. That's what Goddess Effect said. That your mother is disgusted by you. So you get up here and you take your hatred of Black women, your dissatisfaction, your disappointment, that's projection. You're the nigga that's disappointed with your mother being an ain't shit bitch that ain't never accomplished shit. See, you're not the one that's the accomplished motherfucker in your family. Your sister is a completely different situation. You're the bum of the family. You are your mama's disappointment. Hey, Miss Young Sniper. Who the fuck is Allie but the resident drunk in the sector? And if that bitch has a fucking degree in psychology and she gets up here and starts diagnosing motherfuckers, that bitch can be sued. And her license can be snatched. So keep referring motherfuckers to Allie as if she's some resident psychiatrist. And your ass gonna get the D. Durrell treatment. And motherfuckers will start calling the goddamn board, and any goddamn license you got will be the fuck revoked on your motherfucking ass. Allie ain't a motherfucking thing but a drunk ass panel hopping, panel prostitute, chat room concubining, resident fucking drunk. If she got any type of motherfucking degree and she's up here on YouTube using it to diagnose motherfuckers, she better give a goddamn disclaimer before she open her motherfucking mouth. She's yet another goddamn clout chaser that was over there, up round by, up there, over there at Pastor Wilson's house, up under Pastor Wilson's nuts. Don't nobody pay no attention to y'all weirdos. And don't no goddamn body support your channels for that fucking reason, because you a motherfucking weirdo. Motherfuckers don't like you because they don't like you. Stop being up here with your 55-year-old ass whining and crying and complaining. And complaining because motherfuckers don't like you and they like somebody else. I be he up here talking about Allie like she's some resident in psychiatry. No, she's the resident drunk. She's the resident paymaster. That's the only reason why y'all keep that weird cackling like a motherfucking hyena ass bitch around. The only goddamn way that bitch is going to get anybody to her motherfucking chat room is if she put one of our names in the titles. Nobody pays that weird bitch any mind. Fuck out of here. He fed the sector. Motherfucker, you don't even know the content creators in this sector. Again, you haven't even seen their content creators in this sector. The beef sector, probably they may have seen Bomb Cheery on Miss Olivia's panel. But the beef sector hasn't even met all of the content creators in this sector. They only have met the ones that y'all keep talking about, which is actually disrespectful. Because there are a lot of vets in this sector that have been here and paid dues on this platform. A lot of these motherfuckers are newcomers. Hell, I'm a newcomer in the sector as it pertains to somebody like Beasley. Beasley has been here forever. Hey, Intentional Rain. Hey, Triple. But no, I thought that was disgusting. To basically, that was so invalidating to sit there and tell her basically everything that she's trying to explain. You know what was the other thing that's interesting about that, sis? That's the reason why I fell out with this dude. Because he got on my fucking panel, right? That's really what set it off. He got on my panel and wanted to give me the history between him and Jazzy G. No. I don't want to hear all that shit. What the fuck do that got to do with me? And again, sis, what does your support of me have to do with you and Firebabe's history? Why is that his business? If you're addressing him about the long-standing beef between you and Firebabe, why is he so focused on you supporting me and my champ? And make no mistake about it, eventually everybody is either, he is a pick-a-side ass type of nigga. It's a you, he is a you can't like nobody else but me ass nigga. So I'm glad you didn't hit that fucking nigga's link. He don't hold no fucking right. Feed the sector. Bitch, you can't even keep your gas on and you talking about feeding the sector? You can't even pay water to wash your ass with. And if you weren't paying your motherfucking water bills, how the fuck were you cleaning your house? Were you cleaning your house with toilet water? It's nothing that a nigga that had to clean his house and wash his ass with jugs of goddamn spring water can say to me, bitch. Period. How are you washing your dishes? With spring water you had to buy from the poppies? If you don't shut your bitch ass up. But he had to feed the sector. He can't keep his house warm, but he can feed the sector. He can't get his car fixed. He can't get body work done on his vehicle, but he can feed the sector. He can't get his house out of foreclosure for non-payment for that second mortgage he swindled Miss Hazel into taking out on that goddamn property. Which is why Hazel Myrick is still listed on the goddamn deed. But he can feed the goddamn sector. Bitch, if you didn't get up here and beg, you wouldn't be able to feed yourself. You was calling your moderator, let's get it, and asking her to buy you pizza, you broke ass bitch. Yeah, of course he is. Of course he is, Itsy Bitsy. Because see, keep in mind, Firebabe is a send-off bitch too. Make no fucking mistake about it. That is his hidden agenda. Good morning, Fashionista. That's his hidden agenda. See, it started off with him going after the weakest link. And look what he did to the women. Tracy is not the fucking weakest link. But he tried it though. He went from platform to platform. Why did he turn against Olivia? Again, because he thought he was going to bring his old ass over there on that geriatric gigolo shit and be able to finesse them and their platforms. See, as long as they let him up on the platform and be seen, he ain't have a problem with nothing. It was only when the chicks in the beef sector started clocking. And by the way, I found this old video regarding pimps and what the news used to say about pimps. Now, I'm doing my research on the Monster of Paris right now for tomorrow's stream. But I wanted to do, when I found that soundbite, I said, listen, all of these black males that are going around here glorifying this pimp shit. It will be interesting to do a live stream on the history and the way the wide stream media used to perceive pimps. That's not no rite of passage. So let me get this right. It's okay for him to be glorified as a pimp and as fuck that ladies' man shit. Not only is he a woman beater, he's a womanizer. There's nothing family oriented or community oriented about that. But he ain't got no problem with they referring to him as a geriatric gigolo, as a pimp. He don't mind that stereotype. But yes, I found that soundbite and I said, you know what? This would make for interesting commentary. Rita said, my side been picked, so it's all good. Everybody think old girl can make it shake, but the facts are Rita holds the content and the receipts. Anybody will tell you that's why she going nuts. They need me, right? Because I remember when Rita had took a hiatus. And they still were talking about Rita. Rita wasn't even going live. And they were still in the beef sector, as far as Fire Baby's concerned, and her commentary, it was dry. She was riding around the beef sector on Kwani's back. Like the camel face bitch that she is. Stomp Down was right about that. Looking for something to drink. Riding on her camel. And bitch, I'm still waiting for you to come outside the house, bitch. So I can virtually beat you across your knees with a goddamn baseball bat. I'm still on your ass, bitch. Hey, Tracy 3. Hey, Nanya. See this type of shit here? You cowardly ass bitch. You know, but yeah, I feel that that would make it interesting, you know, to open up the panel. And to have that conversation and to look back in retrospect, it was a time when black people that had any type of class and dignity would be embarrassed to be associated with pimps. And the first thing that the news commentator said, and if I'm not, it wasn't Walter Cronkite, who the hell? It was another well-known news reporter. Started off saying that the majority of pimps are black. Because that ties right into black, what do they call it? The black exploitation? Black exploitation, rather. And where men started degrading black women and presenting them as prostitutes, as women of low value, as low hanging fruit. So thank you, beautiful soul. Maz, if you could stop, if you could start dropping the links for the content creators from both sectors that came into the chat room, please. Hey, Michi Black. But yes, I just thought that that, right, Hanlon, I just thought that that was so invalidating for him to do that, to basically tell them, first of all, to try to dictate what they do or how they do it in the beef sector, period. You can't go over there and tell them people how to do what the fuck they do. That's what their sector is. That's the pretense of their sector. Or the, put it this way, the theme of their sector. He ain't trying to do shit but build a fucking harem. That's it. Point blank, period. He's not doing shit when he visits anybody's channel but recruiting goddamn flying monkeys. He don't give a rat's ass about the truth. The truth came out last night in part on Pizarro's panel. The truth is in the receipts on Hennywise's channel. The proof is in the receipts that Reed put out. They ain't interested in no receipt and no proof. The proof is when she got popped as playing in everybody's faces when Rita put the receipts out. That the chick that she bought out here telling everybody new China doll in order to basically, and everything that this bitch has done makes you look back on certain shit in retrospect. Everything. She brought that woman out here because she's seen it as an opportune way to be able to discredit Treacy or to turn everybody against Treacy. And she used Clydeva to be able to do it. Let me see what author you named. Let me go up in the chat and see which author that you named. LV Demir Dory Diamond to Pearl said, Cookie, I will attend. Excellent concept to discuss pimps and blaxploitation. Donald Goings would be a good literary reference. Let me write that down. I got my paper here. So I got to finish. I got to go, y'all, and make my grandson lunch and I'm going to be doing, I may try, what I may do, and I'm going to be limiting the true crime to an hour. What I may start doing is doing the true crime in the mornings, okay, for an hour or the morning or the early part between, I may do it around noon and then do an evening stream where I open up the panel where we just have an open, where I come up with a topic. And then we have a panel to discuss that. But in the morning, we'll do, hey, ask April. We'll do the, okay. Tamra said she still has all her. I'm writing that down. So I can do, once I finish with this, I'm trying to actually find pictures of the victims for the Monster of Monmart. Or Monster Mart. I'm trying to figure out how to pronounce some of these words because this is a crime that occurred in Paris. So I'm thinking, yes, beautiful soul. I was thinking that would be something that people during the workday that they could tune into, to listen to, between noon. We can have true crime at lunchtime. Okay. And then later on in the evening, I can open up the panel and we can have a topic of discussion such as the blaxploitation. Okay, so I'm definitely going to look that up, Donald Goings, as soon as I'm finished with this research. Okay, And Joyce from the beef sector had gave me some information about how to set up the call-in number. So I'm going to work on that, do a little bit of my, finish up my research for the story tomorrow, for tomorrow for lunchtime. And then we can maybe do the Blaxploitation story tomorrow. Okay, tomorrow evening, right? Okay. So again, Maz, if you could drop the links to all of the content creators from both the beef sector and the black sector, anybody that you may recognize as a content creator, in the chat that I may not have seen or I may have missed, and we can do that. And I'm going to go back to my Saturday kind of the Saturday juke joint thing, where that's a time for us to be able to just do something different and just enjoy some oldies but goodies, some old R&B, you know? But yes. Hey, Brandy. Right. Okay. So Dory is also a content creator, Mods. If you could drop the link to her channel, please. Tracy 3. Are you a content creator? I know you're from the beef sector, but are you a content creator too, sis? I love you more, Brandy. Ha ha! Listen, Handling. We gonna start WDAS in it. WDAS FM. That used to be the shit in Philadelphia on Sundays, the oldies but goodies. We've been waiting. What's the song, Hanlon? We've been waiting for so long. We want to play for you some of our songs. But you by God. Listen, if they don't know that, they ain't no native Philadelphian, man. That's what we grew up on. WDAS, baby. And Power 99 FM, that was more like the younger, hipper rap, you know, like the rap, kind of like the rap genre. Oh, okay. All right, Tracy 3. All right, but yeah, you know, I just wanted to say, Reed, at the end of the day, sis, your frittata Saturday video. No, Italian biker, I got to check it out. Are you talking about the dude that they put to death that actually had his wife murdered, his ex-wife murdered, the mother of his children murdered in the driveway? Is that who you're talking about? The name just sounds familiar. Just sound like somebody that I've seen on death row in Texas for some reason. I'm thinking at that name. Is that who you're talking about? But I will definitely go and check it out. And Diet Melanin and Italian Biker are also content creators. So is Shady Tales. Okay? And his wife is My Diva, for those of you that didn't know. My Diva's Neighborhood. I know the beef sector may know, but some people over here may not know. Oh! All right, I'm sorry, Ivy. It sounded like something. Listen, it was a dude that was an Italian dude that they had just basically they put him to death because he hired two hitmen to murder his ex-wife in the driveway. Okay, but right, I know Italian Biker, you all, has him and his wife, they do comedy skits and stuff like that too, but they also have They also cook. So, Maz, if you could grab his link, I would appreciate it. And to the Diet's channel. Diet be acting a damn fool over there, but the beef sector will love it. That's right up your alley. Okay? All right, guys. You enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll catch up with you guys later on. All right, I'm about to make my grandson some lunch and sit down and have lunch with him. And do my research. All right. I'll catch up with you later. Peace. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, everybody. Oh, before I go, I just wanted to say, Rita Reed It doesn't matter who validates your who invalidates your experience. We overstand how triggering that could be, or how as a mom to hear somebody attacking your children, that is probably the most triggering thing that anybody could ever do. It doesn't matter if your children, it's all the more disgusting when it's a minor. But that's what they do. Again, that's one of the first things that they do. And I can relate. I can relate to the way that you feel, because that's one of the first things that they attack when it comes to me. Even though my children aren't on YouTube, and even though my children are adults, they're still my children. So to explain that away, or to invalidate somebody else's experience and say, well, even though that happened to you, just get over it. Oh, just get over it. Don't complain about it. Oh, just let bygones be bygones. But they're not going to give the other person that same advice. And if you think back, y'all, mother was just talking about that. If you're saying this to me, are you saying this to the other person? If not, it's offensive, or it can be perceived as offensive. Because why are you telling me how to respond to what a person is doing to me, especially if the person initiated? So you don't need that chump, you don't need validation from that fucking chump. We understand. And we empathize with you. Period. Going to invalidate somebody else's experience about their children being a fuck attack because you clout chasing, or because you want to be a send off ass nigga, and you perceive something to be gained by kissing this bitch's ass. She going to use your motherfucking ass up and throw you away just like she did any and every motherfucker. You think all them people in the beef sector got the same story about this bitch because it ain't no truth to it? She going to use your old decrepit ass up. And you already hopping around like a goddamn dog with a goddamn broken leg. And I can't wait for your ass to be hobbling around these YouTube streets. Because see, just like the beef sector hasn't met all the content creators over there, you don't know all the content creators in the beef sector. You just know the ones that you clout chasing. When them little or smaller content creators, and including some of the vets that have been over there that you haven't met yet, that you haven't heard about, when they come out the woodworks, you haven't even met, you don't even know all the gay men, openly gay men over there. You only know certain names because you are a clout chaser. There is a plethora of content creators in the beef sector. You're only acknowledging the ones that you're clout chasing after. You're not about to go over there and run shit. You think the names that you named are the only ones that you got to contend with in that beef sector, and you're going to get just what you get. I can't wait for your old decrepit ass to be hobbling along. I can't wait for you to think you're going to go over there to the beef sector and be the self-appointed, the new king of the beef sector. And for them other content creators that you know nothing about to come out the woodworks and gnaw your fucking ass down to the bone. Because I'm going to come out here on the YouTube streets and kick your motherfucking carcass. Point blank, period. You can't go up in somebody else's house and on somebody else's turf and think you're going to have the advantage. Because you don't. That's just his arrogance. I can't wait for him to get over there and for them to rip him apart like a pack of wild dogs. And listen, I'm going to get my whole life. We're going to have I'm going to come out. It's going to be a celebration, bitches. When they rip that nigga to pieces like a pack of wild dogs, when you see the balloons, don't just assume it's because somebody got popped. It's going to be because it's a celebration, bitches. Get into it. Okay? Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, people. Peace.